Hey everyone, welcome to round two. We've won the roll, and so we're going to play first with our sweet little beatdown deck. And this looks fine. We've got a two drop and a three drop, and so we don't want to mulligan. And so our opponent kept his hand also, unlike our last round opponent, and we're gonna just play a swamp and pass. Unfortunately, he plays a swamp also, so our Wrath the Intimidator probably is not going to be the best that it can be. Although, it still does search out a few other guys. So, and that will at least... okay, one less. That will at least make it somewhat useful. So right now, we can only search out a... let's see... an Agent of Shaku, I think. There's also Misshapen Fiend, so... let's see... ooh. I kind of want to trade that off. Let's see if he offers the trade here. No? Alright. So now we're just going to play the Persuader, and then ideally draw some land at some point to tempo him out. Alright, Coastal Piracy for him, so this is going to be rather unfortunate. Nothing for us, so we're just going to beat down again and then play Greel's Caress on his guy. We're going to do that after he attacks with it, so that he can't block with it on his turn. And hopefully he doesn't have a counterspell, because that would be Trey unfortunate. Although that would take up most of his turn, so that's actually not that bad. And alternatively, we could have used our Girl's Crest on his creature that he's playing this turn, but I think for now we'll end up being fine playing it on there, because we don't want to take any more damage. Ooh, a mountain. Alright, so now what we can do is we can just play Shock Troops. Shock is Smugglers, attack with everything. And then he's on 2 life with us having Shock Troops in hand. Pretty good position, I must say. And unfortunately, Bog Smuggler sort of trumps Wrath the Intimidator in this Swamp Mirror. It's going to be sort of difficult, but thankfully we have Shock Troops, which, and other sorts of removal that doesn't really require non-black creatures. His creatures would be non-black for us to work, and we'll see if he can actually draw into a card that lets him survive this turn that with what's on the board only. And Rhystic Siphon, so he's going up to 7. So let's see if he ends up blocking. So I think the play is just to attack with everything, and then if he blocks, we can... if he blocks, then we can blah, blah, blah. Shock him. But it looks like he is blocking, so... we're just going to play Chris Mage, and then Shock Troops, and... he'll probably concede now. We'll have to remember Rhystic Siphon for next time. And it looks like he has foil. Jeez, this guy has everything. Alright. Discarding Belby's Percher. Pretty nifty of him. And he's got nothing. Showing us his hand. Sure, why not? Wrathy Assassin. Destroy target tap non-black creature. Not the best. Although it's still pretty sweet. Tidal Kraken and Rashad and Cut Purse. So that's something to keep to think about. Alright, so our sideboard options are pretty terrible. we have Outbreak, which since in the Mercenary Mirror really isn't that great. We have Wall of Distortion, which doesn't seem like it's that great against his deck either, except against Tidal Kraken. I mean, but against Bog Smugglers and Spineless Thug, it's not that great. I mean, you can block Spineless Thug, but I'd rather just have any other creature and not be spending my mana each turn to affect the board like, or to play a game like that while he's beating down. For red options, we don't really have anything, so I'm just going to go ahead and submit this.